Let's talk about currency markets. Euro has been weakening largely ahead of the European debt summit, with no headway being made on the Greek debt talks. Also, that's a major overhang on the currency. The currency is currently down for the first time in the last six trading sessions. In last week, we saw the euro largely strengthening against the dollar. That seems does not seem to be the case this time around. The US dollar is up largely on rising risk aversion. And of course, some of the high-risk currencies across the Asian markets are also down compared to the US dollar. For instance, the Australian dollar is also extending its decline this morning compared to the dollar and the yen. The Fitch rating cut on five Eurozone nations is also a probable overhang as far as the currency markets are concerned. Let's bring on Philip Wee, senior currency strategist at DBS Bank, joining us on a phone line from Singapore. Philip, thank you so much for taking a call this morning. Let's talk about the currency markets first. Euro seems to have turned a little bit down after a large move over the last five, six trading sessions. Do you think investors, traders are cashing in on the recent gains? Do you expect more downside?
I think if you look at the bigger picture, most of the speculators, they are still net short euro. In fact, it's quite interesting to see those positions building to record levels, even in spite of the euro's climb above 130. I think what they're telling you is that between 140 and 120, the bet is still for euro to fall towards 120 longer term. I think if you look at the drivers of the recent, what we call a relief rally, it's pretty much, I guess, on the back of the ECB liquidity measures of easing concerns about a Lehman-style collapse of the banking system. But that said, I think in most crises, that we've gone through, this is normally the first relief rally, but nonetheless, the overhang remains. What's the growth strategy going forward for Eurozone? And I think we still, I think this is one of the things that's going to hang over markets going forward. So, and the other thing that recent development is that one of the G7 countries have sort of highlighted that the Eurozone crisis is not just about sovereign debt, but it's also potentially a balance of payments crisis. If you look at the numbers, for example, in the first three quarters of 2011, Germany's current account surplus is about almost just as big as the deficit for the whole Eurozone. If you look at Greece alone, both the current account and the budget deficits are about 10% of GDP. So, what you do see is that Eurozone countries, especially the troubled ones, are still in a tough spot, and they're still dealing actually with a twin deficit problem. So, in this kind of situation, it is too early to conclude that the euro may have seen its worst for this crisis.
What's your target as far as the euro and the dollar are concerned?
Well, we have set a target about 120 for the next 3 to 6 months. We still believe that there are still some way off before G20 countries come together, to boost the IMF. For example, Americans still need EU leaders, to combine the ESM with the ESF, basically they want a bailout fund of size about $1 trillion. But at this stage, I think Germany is unwilling to discuss this until the next EU summit in March. And in terms of calendar, thereafter we'll have the G20 finance ministers in April and the leader summit in June. So in terms of calendar, I guess it's still a work in progress.
Philip, thank you so much for joining us this morning, helping us understand how to read into the currency market signal. So clearly, currency markets could be in a bit of a mess right now. Factors across US and Eurozone are currently weighing in.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.